2 Corinthians chapter 1 verses 8 to 11. This happened that we might not rely on ourselves but on God who raises the dead. According to 2 Corinthians 1 9. For this episode, February 8, 2022, title of our topic for today's Bible reading is Loving Others with Our Prayers. Are people still praying for me? That was one of the first questions a missionary asked his wife whenever she was allowed to visit him in prison. He had been falsely accused and incarcerated for his faith for 2 years. His life was frequently in danger because of the conditions and hostility in the prison, and believers around the world are earnestly praying for him. He wanted to be assured they wouldn't stop because he believed God was using their prayers in a powerful way. Our prayers for others, especially those who are persecuted for their faith, are a vital gift. Paul made this clear when he wrote the believers in Corinth about hardships he faced during his missionary journey. He was under great pressure, so much that he despaired of life itself. 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 8. But then he told them God had delivered him and described the tool he'd used to do it. He had set our hope that he will continue to deliver us as you help us by your prayers. Verses 10 to 11. Emphasis added. God moves through our prayers to accomplish great good in the lives of His people. One of the best ways to love others is to pray for them, because through our prayers, we open the door to the help only God can provide. When we pray for others, we love them in His strength. There is none greater or more loving than He. By James Banks. How do you love others with your prayers? In what ways can you encourage prayer for those who are persecuted and for their faith? Loving and Almighty God, thank you for the amazing gift of prayer. In the ways you move through it, please help me to pray faithfully for others today. Thanks for watching.